families come across the way to the parish house for the reception to greet the family over there inside in the pool. And good reception will be prepared for you, and we'll be waiting for you over there. We are offering Holy Communion today as a part of the service. Everything you need for the service will be in your service bulletin that hopefully you have. If you don't, please let our ushers know, Lillian and Bob. They are here to direct you up for Holy Communion. For Holy Communion, all denominations, all Christian denominations, you are welcome to receive Holy Communion here at Old St. Andrews. If you would like to come to the altar for Holy Communion, you may do so. If you'd like to receive in your pews, we have communion kits here at the back, and I would encourage you to get one before the service. Yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. For none of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord, and when we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. We brought nothing into the world, and it is certain we carry nothing out. The Lord gave, the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name
reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep, a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to tear and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity into man's heart, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I perceive that there is nothing better for them than to be joyful and to do good as long as they live, so that everyone should eat and drink and take pleasure in all of his toil. This is God's gift to man. I perceive that whatever God does endures forever. Nothing can be added to it, nor anything taken from it. God has done it so that people fear before him. That which is already has been. That which is to be already is. And God seeks out what is gone by. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. happy anniversary, Jim, and happy birthday, Jim. We are here to celebrate his life. We are here to celebrate the anniversary of his birthday into heaven, if you will, the anniversary of his death a year ago. And when Julia and I first talked about this service and about waiting for this occasion, it immediately seemed to me to be the perfect thing to do. Doesn't take much to get you to think back a year ago and what we were enduring at that point in time. And the idea of coming together and having this celebration of life a year later, it seemed like the right thing to do, and today certainly bears that out. Thank you for being here with us today. You see, life and the Christian faith are about anniversaries, they are about birthdays, they are about remembrances. Our gospel lesson today and Jesus' teaching is from the Last Supper. That, an anniversary, if you will, a Passover meal, an annual remembrance of deliverance from slavery, from bondage, from death, that the people of Israel kept and keep to this day. The Passover, the longest running, the longest continually celebrated anniversary, religious holiday, religious event in the world. And Jesus' teaching here is on that Passover gathering. It is with them all gathered together. He is facing his death. And he gives them this teaching about death and about life and about life ever after, a life that he will pass to after his crucifixion and after his resurrection and then his ascension. At the occasion of this teaching that Jesus gives us about life and about everlasting life, the apostles at this Passover celebration were not in much of a mood to celebrate. It was a very troubled time. And yet in that gathering together of that Passover meal, Jesus recalls the Passover, and yet he transforms it, because that Last Supper became the First Communion when he says, "This bread is my body, and this wine is my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." Week after week, we come together as Christians and we celebrate that meal that's not just a memory, but it's reliving and living into it. It's Holy Communion. It is community. And we as Christians believe that we celebrate that communion as one body with those on this earth and those who are with God and with God himself. And so you see, today we come together for a celebration, not just across the way in the parish house with lots of good stories and good food and drink, but here at God's table on this anniversary, on this birthday celebration for Jim. Jim was pretty straightforward in his instructions about today. And he did not want to be eulogized, but I will say that I loved his faith and I love the connection that we made right off the bat. Someone from Waynesville, my family, has a home up in the mountains, very close by there. And Jim, a Wolfpacker, and I went to college up there close by, although I'm a Dookie. So we had a few good times talking about that. I had a connection with him through North Carolina, but also through faith. I loved his faith. I loved his pride in his family, his love for you all. And most of all, I loved his love for Julia. 55 years of celebrating anniversaries, of celebrating family gatherings. And we celebrate that today. Family and friends gathered here together to remember a man who loved to celebrate and loved family and loved life. So I encourage you today to think about times in your life, anniversaries in your life, birthdays in your life. Jim had his birthday into heaven a year ago, and we're celebrating his first birthday today of being with God. 1 year ago yesterday. The word Eucharist is actually a word that means a celebration, even a party, is Eucharistic. And as we come to God's table to celebrate Jim's faith and his life and his family, I encourage you to give thanks to God for Jim on this, his birthday celebration. So happy birthday, Jim. Amen. Amen. Please stand with me now and affirm your faith in the words of the Creed.
Let us pray, saying, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant, we pray to you, to your whole church in heaven and on earth, your light and peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, that through the grave and gate of death we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you in faithful obedience. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to all whom a sure confidence in your fatherly care, that casting their grief on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, grant us grace to entrust Jim to your never-failing love. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, and remember him according to your favor, which you show to all your people. Lord, in your mercy, grant that increasing in the knowledge and love of you, he may go from strength to strength in the life of perfect service in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
and forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Amen.